Hey guys, it's Nishant. Welcome to Cybernetico. Today we will learn about React Router in React. So what is React Router? It is a React library which is used for routing from one page to another. Just like link tags in HTML, we use React Router in React. The advantage of using router is that it is much faster than simple link tags in HTML. So let me get right into it and show you how it works from practical code. So in this app, you can see I have a sidebar which points to home, photos, settings, profile and messages. We have 5 menu items which will point out to different screens or links. First, we need to install the React router. So use npm install react router dom or just yarn add react router dom. So install it. Then you can see we have the routing here, basic routing. We have nested routing here, link inside a link. We have all the options here, what to do in the 404 error, in sidebar, animated transition, everything else. But let's focus on simple routes first. We need to import a few things from this React router package. First is this browser router. So here in this app.js, we are calling the sidebar component here in this return. So let's import first this browser router from React Router DOM. So import browser router. And here let's call it like this in this return. Wrap the sidebar in this browser router. This basically means whatever is inside this browser router will be able to use React routing. We can also simplify this import like it says here, browser router as router. So if you type router here and place router here instead of browser router, it will still work and it will be simplified. Now our step one is complete. Now let's move to creating routes. Now let's create our routes. First, we need to import route from this React router package. So import route from React router DOM. Then we need to set the routes. So after this div, sidebar menu div, we will use route and inside this we will wrap, inside this we will use the component name. So let's say we have a home component. So import home from home. And you see, let me open the home here. If you see, we have the home which is giving us output of home page text. So inside put home, inside this route wrapping. And save. Now we need to set the path. As you can see, we are setting the path here in this route. So set path here as home. Now let's check. If we go to home here in this address bar, we will see the home page text which is coming from this home page. Sorry, from this home component. Similarly, we can do this for other routes as well. So let's say we have photos. Import photos route. Sorry, import photos component here. From photos. Then put photos instead of home. Now if we go to photos route in the address bar, we will see photos page. But this is a little bit lengthy, and there is a smaller way or a better way to create this route. Just clear this route and make it a self closing tag. Then type component and put home inside as component. This way it becomes in a single line. So save Now see, now if we go to home, home route, we will see our home page and we can repeat it for every other route. So we can use photos and the path is photos here. So if we go to photos, we will see photos. We can do this for all other routes. So let's import settings from settings. Then we will have profile here. So import profile. We have profile menu item. Then messages from messages. Repeat this for 3 more times. Settings, profile and messages. Replace the components in this route and then we'll use settings for settings route. Profile and messages. Now if we go to settings, we will see settings here. Settings, let me make it bolder. So we need to wrap it into an H1 tag. Then we have profile, make it H1. Then we have photos, it's done. Then we have messages, so make it H1. Then let's see, we go to settings, sorry, we go to profile because we all know settings already. So open a profile here, we see profile and we will see messages. Now the next property is link in router. So what is link? Link is used to dynamically send us to other routes. So if we click home, we should be on the home. Photos, we will be on the photos, and so on. So first let's import this link from React Router DOM. Then inside this return we will use link tag. So wrap this li in this link. So we are using this link tag inside this return, inside this map, because we need the link to. So you see we have the two of the route here. So we want the routes from this sidebar menu array. So if you see, we have already this routes declared here. So path is this slash, then photos, settings and profile. So we are importing this paths inside this side, inside this link. So just we need to use two. So you see we have two route here and then equal to and the route name. So we will use dynamic routes here. So just type menu item dot, you see we have settings here, we have the key name of path. So just type menu item dot path and save. Now let's check, click home. We see nothing because we need to make it, or we can change it inside the menu. So click home here. Click home, we see we are on the home page because it is routing us to this menu item dot path. So if we click home, we will be on the home route, this home. So now if we click photos, we will be on the photos page. Settings, we will be on the settings page. Profile, profile page. And messages, messages page. Now you learn, now you know what is this link in this router, React router. Now we have seen the three important properties of router: route, link and browser router. But there is one more property which is called use history. It is used, or it contains the data of that current link or route we are on. So it will, if you are on the home route, it will contain the data of this home page, this home route, photos route, if you are on the photos page, and so on. So let me show you why it is so useful. So first, import use history from React Router DOM, then create a let variable here, history, let history equal to use history. Then we will use this use history to create an active route. So let's say we are on the home page, this home route should be activated or it should be highlighted. And now we will create a state that will contain our active route. So create one state. First, import use state hook from React. Then create a const, let's say active route set active route use state and string. Then we will set the active route here on the click of this link, which will be, wait, we can use on click event. So on click, set active route, set active route to menu item dot path. Now we need to import use effect hook. So import use effect, then create a use effect hook here. So we will console.log our output, this history output, in this use effect. So console.log history. Then we'll use active route in this dependency array. So whenever our active route changes, we will see our history in the console. So open up the console, clear it. Now click home. We see we are getting this object which contains action, block, everything. What we need, this location. So just type here history.location. Save, clear it again and click home. Okay, click home. We see we are getting the path name and everything, key, path name, search. So we can use also path name here because that's all we need. So path name, refresh the page if you want. Now let's check, click home. We see we are getting home route here in this console. Photos, we are getting photos route. Settings, we are getting settings route, profile route, and messages route. So you now understand the function of this history and use history. We can use this use history to create active routes or active class name. So let me show you how it works. So now we will use this active route state to show the activated route with a highlighted color. So in this li tag, we will create a condition. So if active route is equals to this menu item dot path, we will use a custom class name. So let's say in this app.css we have already a class name called active menu. So copy it and paste it. Also we need one more class name. This, wait a second, let me check what was it. Okay, sidebar list. So we will use active menu and sidebar list to show this menu, activate menu. Then if the link is not equal to, active route is not equal to menu item dot path, we will just show this original sidebar list class. So now click home. You see this home is highlighted with black color or gray color. Photos, it is highlighted. Settings, profile, and messages. Now you will have learned how to create this active route using use history in React Router. So that was all about React router package in React. We have learned how to use route, link and use history as well as browser router. So please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching. Cheers. Bye.